This is Lac De Madine, a 2,700-acre expanse of fresh water in the Champagne region of France. It's also the location for the 11th World Carp Classic, the carp fishing world's premier enduro event. Between August the 30th and September the 5th, 2009, Lac De Madine would be the arena in which 130 pairs of anglers from 25 different countries battled it out for the much-coveted title of World Champions. It's Saturday, August 30th. Slowly but surely, the Lac De Madine site is filling up with this year's competitors. Today is their opportunity to complete their official registration for the event. The order in which they register would determine in which order they come up to do the peg draw. Boats are an invaluable tool to carp anglers at Madine, not only due to the extreme range that they need to fish at, but also due to the thick beds of blanket weed that Madine has become synonymous with. For Head Marshal Andy Chambers, there's no time to rest at present, as essential last-minute swim checks are very much par for the course.
Okay, so we're just off to Jetfish Island just to do some re-pegging. We'd done it a couple of days ago, but we had some big winds yesterday, and some of the pegs where we did have some jetfish pegs have been shut, so we have to do a few adjustments just to make sure everybody's got some good pegs for the event. Number three.
For the competitors, today's all about relaxing in the area now known as Bibby City, due to the sheer concentration of anglers' tents in this one area. The event organisers, however, have no respite as they prepare the sports hall for the event's prestigious opening ceremony the next day.
Okay, well, it's great to be here at the World Carp Classic 2009. It looks like it's going to be a really exciting year. We've got more countries than ever before. And for the first time ever, we've got a team competing from Japan. Lac De Madine is the venue that we've selected for the 2009 World Carp Classic. Well, I've been asked and often asked the question, why? The lake itself's absolutely ideal for the competition. It's got a good stock of fish, and it's got some big fish, so let's hope they come out this year. Some of the world's best anglers are here at Lac De Madine, and I look forward to presenting this trophy to the winners.
The day before the competition proper, There's still much for the anglers to think about and prepare for, as they still don't know exactly where they'll be fishing. So what better way to take their minds off the tension of the impending peg draw than enjoying this year's Gladiator Games, organised once again by the inimitable Hans Sissing from Carp Connections in Holland.
Go! Let's go! Look at this team! Come on, guys! Support the ladies!
And I'm a lacquer!
This guy's being sponsored by. We have some competitor here who says he can handle this for two games. It's happening! Yeah. We have a first time! 220!
Yeah.
As the last remaining competitors arrive and complete their registration, Madine and its inhabitants lie in wait, and soon it will be time for the all-important peg draw, preceded by the prestigious opening ceremony.
Let the World Carp Classic 2009 begin. Ladies and gentlemen, we are standing with the flags of all the countries that are participating in the event will be coming through. The flags from all the countries. Here they come. It's a proud moment as you see your flag coming through. Give it a round of applause. To me on the stage, and let me show that to you. They just said that the winners of the event will be given one, and
very kindly, they've also given me one as well. So I'd like to show you what this is like.
Now, they just gave it to Ross as an appreciation of everything he's done for World Carp Classic for the last 11 years.
Next up, it's the peg draw, what all of these top carp anglers have been waiting anxiously for. As with previous years, what happens now will determine whether it's a case of success or failure for the competitors. If an angler is unhappy with the first peg they draw, they can put it back and draw another. It's a risky strategy, but for some it will almost certainly be the key to success. It's the first day of the competition, and today at 3 o'clock the fishing will begin in earnest. Bibby City will soon be a distant memory as the anglers strike their camp and embark on the journey to their swims, which will effectively be their home for the next 5 days. Some swims are close, some are only accessible by boat, but regardless of this, all of these intrepid anglers face an arduous task if they're going to emerge triumphant at the end of the competition. Enduro matches like this require a great deal of physical and mental resolve, as often the elements and of course the fish can be less than forgiving. The World Carp Classic 2009 would prove to be no exception to this unwritten rule. Once the competitors are in their swim, then it's time to set up and begin the all-important task of locating underwater features where their quarry may be lurking. Some will use a boat for this, and some will manage adequately without. Either way, it's an acquired skill, and those who do it successfully are almost guaranteed to reap the rewards.
Right, go downwind a little bit.
About there, right there.
When I haven't been to a water before, then I try not to put too much bait in. Yep. I don't know if these fish are hungry. And so if I've put a lot of bait in and they're not so hungry, it's a big problem. You can't take that bait back out. So I'm going to put a small amount in. I can watch what everybody else is doing. And if they're putting a lot of bait and they're catching, hey, simple, I put some more. We have 500 kilos of bait, so we're not going to have a problem. But to start off with a small amount of bait.
Right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make my good friend Ferry here two special little mixes. One is going to be a straight boily mix with some special bits and bobs put in it. And the second is going to be what we call a cannonball mix. Start by filling a bucket with various pellets of whatever you fancy. And then stick in various things. But you mainly want the juices. You don't want too much hemp in it. Then nice little slapping of corn. And then one of the most important ingredients, the tuna and the oil. And what it does, it brings out the colours of everything. And once these pellets have broken down a bit, you'll actually be moulding it in a giant method ball or a cannonball as big as, you know, like a big melon. You put your lead in the middle, wrap your hook link around the outside, pat it down, and then you lower it down off the edge of the boat. But you need to make it up the night before so that the pellets and everything soaks down nicely. So that's the first one. Then we move over to here. We've just got a big bucket of boilies. So we've got a half sensible bucket of boilies. And then again in goes one of the magic ingredients. Tuna in the oil. A little bit of dip. And what you'll find is that you leave this overnight and the baits soak it all up. Not only adds more attraction or immediate attraction in the swim with oils coming off the bait, it actually stops them going off, and you can actually semi-preserve a bait in the swim, so you can use freezer baits if you need to, and you can stop them going off and going mouldy. Okay, well, I've now finished my stuff that I'm going to give to Ferry. He's coming over now. It's a pleasure to fish with you again, my friend. I've got you some special stuff here from England. These are the boilies that I want you to use.
Fantastic.
And this is going to be your cannonball mix. So you can either use that, mould it in the big balls, or you can just spread it around your swim, around your marker, and then fish those over the top. You'll be fine. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Although the fishing began at 3, the carp of Madine remain uncooperative for the time being, and perhaps some begin to question whether the tournament would live up to all the hype this time round. The night passed somewhat uneventfully, as the carp didn't begin to feed in numbers. However, there were some fish caught, including the first fish of the competition, so Andy Chambers heads over to the fishing and hunting section to verify the catch. And so, the World Carp Classic 2009 is off to a flyer, as Marek Kwiatkowski from Poland displays this fine 16-kilo common for the world's angling press. As it transpired, they haven't been the only ones to catch, and so the team of Sparsholt College marshals are called into action. On the second day, the competition was starting to take shape, and as the carp began to feed, there'd be more anglers who would reap the rewards of their previous labours.
Oh,
first of many.
It was a feeding spell that would continue well into the night, and perhaps there was the first suggestions that this year's World Carp Classic might just be something special. Things were certainly going well for Turban and Walters as the Dutch pair soon banked another fish in the shape of this 15.9 kilo mirror. It was this fish that would give them a healthy lead at the end of the second day.
Bring your grandma.
Day 3 is barely a couple of hours old before something really special occurs. British angler Jason Cairns smashes the World Carp Classic record with a gargantuan 26.1 kilo mirror. And naturally, he's quite elated.
Come to daddy.
Yeah.
And, you know, if you're going to get a hook pull, that's when it is.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, luckily everything just stayed firm and...
That was it.
You know, a mouth like that just came really? Up, took a gulp of air and just went... And I went, don't come off now. You know, because no one's ever going to believe you.
Yeah, yeah. You know? It's the big one that got away.
Yeah, yeah. What's the
big one? Luckily for him, it didn't. And those around stood in awe as Jason and Frank held up this awesome beast for the cameras once daylight had broken. This monster wasn't the only fish that was caught, as many other teams had benefited from the carp's nocturnal feeding frenzy. Meanwhile, on Madine's largest island, English pair Rob Tuff and Tom Duncan Dunlop had really been getting stuck in, as they had no less than four huge fish for the marshals to weigh in. As it turns out, Rob and Tom have some innovative new products at their disposal to outwit the wariest of carp.
That's a weed. So we have leaders, weedy leaders, brown weed. Green weed, it's lead core. It's woven with synthetic weed. Tommy here, of course, has developed these and we've been testing these for a year or two. It's just maybe if you get some carp a bit wary of feeding line, you know, maybe they're sort of feeding the line or seeing it, and with this, you know, they're just not going to see line. It's just weed to them. And these are going to be launched when is it, about a month or two in England.
Yeah. Solar Tack will be very soon.
So they're going to be on the market very soon. And they certainly sort of proved successful with rainbow and lakes and some large carp getting caught on these rigs.
Tricky clear gravel pits also, as you can tell. Yeah. Excellent.
Whilst Rob and Tom are now in the lead, it's not going to be an easy ride, as many other pairs are still enjoying success. Dawn breaks once again over Madine, and it's now day four of this epic contest. It's becoming clear that the match will be won or lost at night due to the sheer number of captures during the hours of darkness. The previous night was again productive, with many more anglers getting a piece of the action.
Baiting on the long swim and with some pellets, some hemp, big pellets, small pellets, a little bit of corn, and also the new boilies we are testing here right now. It's this one is liver shellfish flavor, and it really went well for us, so we're really testing it quite good actually. We are fishing four rods, three other rods have other bait, and we caught the 22 kilo mirror carp on the new test boilies for Berkeley. So perfect, good success. At 3 o'clock it was in the morning, we got a full run. Really, we are 200 meters out, and when we went in the boat, it was, the fish was already 300 meters away. So really full run, and it was not such a long struggle, but it's not so deep there, but it was a massive fish. First I thought it was only 15 kilos, the first glimpse I got of it. But afterwards, it was it's a huge fish. It was a very long fish. Perfect, fantastic. My World Carp Classic has been perfect.
At this point, it was time for Robert Valkenier from title sponsor JRC to hand out welcome bags to the anglers. These included end tackle from JRC, along with carp buster hooks and Ultima line, all of which were gladly received by all of the anglers. Back on the large island, it seemed that Rob Tuff and Tom Duncan Dunlop from England were angling into an unassailable lead. Whatever it was they were doing, they were getting it spot on, as carp after carp fell to the might of their rods. Not only did they land fish live for the cameras, they also had fish waiting in the sack ready to be weighed in. Thank you. sooner had they put these fish back, Rob was in again. Absolutely sensational angling from the Carp World pair. Although Rob and Tom had really been hauling, there was now a problem, as the high gales meant a temporary ban on boats for safety reasons, leaving them with only one line out in the water. Nevertheless, Rob Tuff was still feeling confident.
Unfortunately now we've got one rod left in the water. Yeah. It's actually in 3 foot of water. There's a margin on the right hand side. Yeah. We've had two takes, and we lost one and landed a 30 pound or 14 kilo. So we're just leaving that there because we will move it. You know, it hasn't paid off. All the other rods have been catching now. But the other three rods we've caught on them this morning when the wind got up and we just couldn't get back out there. So waiting for the wind to abate a little bit.
Yeah,
and now we found some spots which were hard. You know, we didn't know they were mussel beds. And we were catching on those hard spots in around some soft areas, and it's just a little bit harder. When we went out there with feature finding, little rod with a lead just to donk down and find. And then the fish we were catching and sacking, they were excreting mussel shells all over. So we know they must be feeding on mussel beds. And hopefully that's at night. They'll be coming back in and moving in onto those spots again. That's the idea. That's the plan. I've done this for 11 years, and this is by far the best opportunity I've had, and the best situation with fish. So Tom and I, my partner, who's catching up with some sleep, we're just hoping that we can carry on catching. Don't want to be greedy, we'd like to catch the a fish that would top Jason and Frank's 57 pounder, I think 26 kilos. So that would
was
be
a nice one there.
Yeah, we would really love to have something like that. That would be fantastic.
Can imagine.
But that might be greedy, so we'll settle.
Why not?
We'll settle with which ones we're catching.
You work hard for it. I've seen it this morning.
Well, yeah,
with the wind and
what goes around comes around, and you take the rough and the smooth, and at the moment it's smooth, and we're enjoying
it. That's true. Yeah, you're right.
Despite Rob's optimism, the atmosphere was still very tense, as over on the Indy Line section, Bert Turban and Koos Walters from Holland were pushing for the lead all the way.
So then, here we are. We're at with Koos and the team from Ultima. So how do you feel, guys? I mean, you know, you're right up there at the moment.
Yeah, we feel good. I mean, it's been after the draw. We thought, well, we're in the middle. We're not on a point swim, so it's going to be a bit harder, but. I think we're doing pretty well. We're feeling great. I mean, the adrenaline is pumping every time we get a fish because, well, we've had 7 fish so far, and at the moment we're the runners-up, and every time we get a bit closer, you know? So, yeah, it feels really good. But we try to stay in second place. We hope we continue catching between 3 and 4, maybe 2 fish a night in the same average we've been catching so far.
Because
the average fish in Madine is big.
Yeah.
I mean, our average at the moment is 34 English pounds.
Right.
15 and a half kilos over 7 fish, which ain't bad, is it?
The final full day of the competition was only a few hours old when the impossible happened. The World Carp Classic biggest fish record was smashed for the second time. German angler Axel Wacker emphatically beating Jason Kahn's fish with this incredible 28.9 kilo mirror carp.
28.9!
You can't be unhappy with that though.
Happy? 28.9, new record.
Okay, yeah. Well done, boys.
Very good fish.
Good, well done.
that.
With the winds having dropped, anglers were once again able to get out in their boats, and luckily the carp were still feeding in numbers. As for the leaders, Rob Tough and Tom Duncan Dunlop were still quietly confident that the match would swing their way.
We've had three hectic days of carp. First day we lost a fish. We dropped some baits on a
10 o'clock in the evening the first day, wasn't it? 10 o'clock in the evening the first day.
We decided just to drop four rods with a micro cap rather than go out there with a boat in case there were fish in the area. And we lost the fish the first night, which we were disappointed with. And the second day, second evening, we just started catching, and then we had 3 days of hectic action, landing 20 carp, five or six 40 plus pound fish, and then a lot of 30s, a couple of upper 30s. Actually, on the draw itself, we had a putback
situation
where you can take your first peg, look at the swim. So we had to do the homework. We spent a day actually going around as much as we could on mountain bikes, looking at the areas. So when we had the draw, and we had always not so bad from an ATT section, which was a new section, we thought, well, would we go there, should we? But no, Tom said, you know, let's go for a gamble, which we did. And we came out next to the winning peg from last year, and we made the right choice, so we couldn't be happier.
Good morning, I'm Artie Veldkamp. I come from Holland. This is my second time I fished the World Carp Classic. I really enjoy it. And last year I was fishing with Frank Warwick and Jason. This year I'm with Ruud Hageman and Shope. We have a good team together, but we didn't draw a good place. And then you can try what you can do. We tried all our tactics together, but until now there's not any fish out of this place. The rest, I think, this year is a very good competition. Many big fish are caught. The weather is reasonable. It's a shame it's a little bit turning now into rain. And I enjoy it a lot. I think it's good to bring all the competitors all around the world together. Especially, I see friends from South Africa, from America, and we all see each other here again. It's like a reunion every year. I think this is very good for fishing and for a friendship between the anglers. We use the Ultima Power Carp as a main line in the 18 pound version. But the most important thing, we use a very good snag leader. And I want to show you something. Ruud, can you help me out with this? This is Ruud Hageman, by the way.
Hello.
I learned a lot from this man. I know him already for 20 years. Hou hem goed strak. This is the scissor. This is the snag leader, and I can show you how tough this is. Especially last year when I lost a big fish on the mussels. It's still going. Since I started using this product, I caught a lot of more big fish.
Right, my name's Tim Paisley. I'm the owner of Carp World magazine. I'm the captain of the Carp World team, which is winning at the moment. This is my vice captain, Lee Jackson, legendary chef and carp angler from England. We've been fishing in this event since 1998. We seem to get a lousy draw every time, but our team is doing well, and that's good enough for us. 3 years on the trot, to win the team event 3 years on the trot, we're mightily proud of that. Very, very excited about it. We didn't think it was possible. Rob Tuff and Tom Duncan Dunlop, and our boys over here, Mark Bartlett and Kevin Hewitt, they're making it possible for us again. So we're not non-playing captains, we're just non-catching captains this year, but we keep trying.
It wasn't long before the wind picked up again, which necessitated another ban on the boats. So the current leaders would have to wait anxiously to see if the conditions would improve. It was fast approaching 8 a.m. on Saturday the 5th of September, and in a matter of minutes, this epic contest would be over for another year. With the last few hours having proved productive for Rob Tuff and Tom Duncan Dunlop, in the end they were runaway champions of the World Carp Classic 2009. Having been in their swims for the best part of a week, it was now time for the anglers to pack away and head back to the event's headquarters for the prize-giving ceremony.
So, the 11th World Carp Classic is absolutely amazing. We've had so many records broken here this year. We've had more countries participate. We've had people travel from further afield, from Japan, from South Africa, from all over the world that are here. Every single type of angling condition we've experienced. Hot weather, storms, rain, and this morning as we're getting everybody back into their pegs or back into the shore, wind as well. So, it's been an incredible year. Not only that, the fish, they've played their part as well. It's been tremendous. There's been well over 150 carp caught. Every fourth carp that's been caught is nearly over 40 pounds, which is incredible. The weights have been brilliant. The World Carp Classic record has been broken twice this year in this competition. First, it got broken by Jason Kahn and Frank Warwick with a weight of 26.1 kilos, which was incredible. And we thought that was great. But then 28.9 kilos came through to actually break the new World Carp Classic record, which is amazing. There's been more fish caught this year than any other year, and all the records have been broken. So we're looking forward to going through to the prize giving and handing out the prizes to the deserved winners. It's been a hard event this year. It's been well fought in great spirit. It really is carp love in the very best way.
But then after the first 48 hours, I think, we had four fish and we knew we made a chance. We were in first place for
a little while. But then Rob Tuff and his mate Thomas, who get all credit, started catching really well.
World Carp Classic's been for the 11th in a row now. And the good thing I like about it is the fact that the fish are becoming bigger and bigger and bigger. And now we have a perfect record, almost 29 kilos.
We'll come back next year.
For us, it's not about the fishing, it's friendship and meeting all the new guys. And for us, it was an experience to get our first fish. We really enjoyed that.
Short summary, obviously, it's been very hectic, but it's been some great fish caught. Three fish over last year's record. I've been out sorting the boats out today, so I don't know how many fish have been caught, but I'd imagine over 150 big carp, lots of 20 kilos, plus for 28.9 kilos. So the fishing has been absolutely awesome.
Fantastic. And to share it with Frank, we go all over the world fishing together. We fish as a team everywhere we go, even when we fish for pleasure. It was a great moment.
Oh, I loved it. Everything about it was awesome. I've seen a lot of people that I haven't seen in a long time. I made a lot of new friends, you know, a lot of fun.
Well done. Okay. Cheers. Because with an incredible 347.5 kilos, 26 fish from England, it gives us great pleasure to present the 2009 World Carp Classic champions to Rob Tuff and Thomas.
Spelling mistakes.
Here we go, let's hear it for them guys, the 2009 World Carp Classic champions.